I'm going to tell you how to eliminate distracting reflections on glass by using anti-reflective glass. What is anti-reflective glass? It's created by taking low iron glass and dipping it into metal oxide solutions. The glass is then heated to 500 degrees Celsius to create oxidic layers that eliminate reflections. The end result of this process has an extremely high clarity, which can be used in a wide variety of applications, especially in bright areas where reflection would prevent visibility. Anti-reflective glass is used in museum exhibits, which is why it is often referred to as museum glass. It's also commonly used in retail storefronts, classy restaurants, and for showcasing multi-million dollar art. It has a hard coating that withstands tempering to enhance safety and security. This makes it perfect for upscale applications where the general public or children may be close to the glass. When people are pressing up against the glass, for example, in an outdoor application such as a zoo, this is a crucial feature to ensure that the glass is strong enough to keep people safe. Because it's anti-reflective, viewers are able to maintain more distance from the exhibits to see clearly, so they have the ability to stand back from the glass. It's the high light transmission combined with the reduced reflection that makes the anti-reflective glass a truly magical piece of glass. This combination will eliminate the sight-inhibiting reflections from the glass, allowing a potential customer to see the showcased item with crystal clear clarity. In this video, I'm going to take you through the features, how it works, its common uses, and what makes an investment in a higher grade glass worth it. Hi, I'm Jessica with Optical Mirror. Every week we bring you new content based on our expertise in the glass and mirror manufacturing industry. Anti-reflective glass, also known as AR glass or museum glass, features an optical coating on one or both sides. The beauty of this optical coating is that it will eliminate the reflections that are commonly observed on normal, everyday glass, while increasing the light transmission through the glass. Museum glass has a substantially smaller reflectivity rate when compared to regular glass. Regular glass is about 8% reflective, while museum glass is about 1% reflective. So, to put it in layman's terms, museum glass allows a person to see through it without having to dodge those pesky glares and reflections that would be observed with regular glass. Another feature of the museum glass that is not to be ignored is it blocks 99% of UV light and it has a low iron substrate. This combination allows museum glass to appear completely clear, eliminating the greenish tint that is commonly observed with standard glass. It's this feature that makes museum glass perfect for placing over expensive, one-of-a-kind art pieces. Standard, everyday glass does not block UV light, which can damage the painting over time. However, museum glass possesses the ability to block those harmful rays. Now, I'm going to take you through some of the other exciting features. Museum glass is also completely waterproof and scratch-resistant. This makes it perfect for outdoor installations and is actually one of the biggest upgrades a store can make for its display windows. I mean, think about it. When a storefront is using standard glass and new potential customers walk by the store window and can't see inside, but instead are overwhelmed with the city reflections and their own reflection, they're probably not going to take the time to go inside to see what the store has to offer. However, if a person is walking by a storefront that is utilizing museum glass and can see the eye-catching pieces on display inside of the store, chances are they will decide to go into the store and check out what else the store has to offer. All of this sounds great, but how exactly does it work? Museum glass has a really thin, hard film that's layered on the glass. This film has an index refraction that measures somewhere between air and glass. An index refraction is basically just a measurement of how fast light travels through the material. This means that the intensity of the light reflected from the inner surface and the light reflected from the outer surface are pretty much the same. The two reflections from either side of the glass actually cancel each other out through a destructive interference. This is what provides the minimized reflection. So now we know what museum glass is and how it works, but what is it used for? With all of the special qualities that museum glass has to offer, the uses of it are pretty broad. It's used in, of course, museums. but also in storefronts, eyeglasses, zoos, and so much more. For museum projects, museum glass helps provide protection to the exhibits from harmful UV light and makes the painting easier to see, even in commercial lighting conditions. In stores, you can easily find museum glass installed on outside windows of the shop. The purpose of this is to entice potential customers, luring them inside simply by the pieces displayed directly behind the glass. However, stores also utilize museum glass inside of the store by housing a display of delicious glazed donuts or diamond jewelry. Jewelry stores are also well known for using museum glass for the same reason. When someone is in the market for pricey jewelry, they want to be able to get a good look at it without having to dodge the reflections of bright showcasing lights. While they could have a piece taken out of the display case to see it better, they're not going to know which item they want to view if there's a glaring reflection bouncing back at them. Everyday eyeglasses also utilize this fantastic piece of glass. The purpose of this is to minimize the reflection from everyday light, while allowing more light to your eyes. Now, picture this. You're going to the zoo with your family and you want to look at the tigers. However, when you're looking at the animal exhibit, all you see is your puzzled reflection looking back at you. No one wants that. Zoos choosing to go with museum glass ensures that you will have the best experience possible when looking at those tigers. Last but certainly not least, we have teleprompters. Teleprompter mirrors are made from beam splitter glass, which has an anti-reflective coating on the back side of the mirror. This coating helps to reduce ghosting text, which makes it easier for the presenter to read. You'll be able to deliver a speech efficiently without squinting or making embarrassing mistakes. Teleprompters are not only used for college speeches, but also for news anchors, politicians, presidential candidates, and even celebrities to help keep their lines straight. Now, let's talk about the upkeep of museum glass. Museum glass is extremely easy to clean. You can use a regular glass cleaner. Personally, we like to use isopropyl alcohol and a microfiber cloth. A lot of people think that anti-reflective glass and anti-glare glass are the same thing, which is an easy assumption to make. However, they do have their differences. Museum glass or anti-reflective glass takes both external and internal light sources into consideration, while anti-glare glass is only protecting against external sources of light. A lot of times there can be a small visible difference too. Museum glass is clear, normal textured glass, but anti-glare glass tends to have a slight matte finish to it. In installations that require an air gap on both sides, the museum glass will look the best. Anti-glare can be great for paintings, as long as you are able to push the glass right up against the painting. If it isn't directly touching the painting will appear fuzzy and unclear. This is because the anti-glare glass is diffusing particles on the surface facing the air. So it smooths out the reflections caused from lighting while keeping the painting itself looking crisp. Certain glass companies actually offer a blend of these two, so you're getting double protection. So why do clients order it with us? Simple, we don't waste your time. Everyone has deadlines and they need that glass quickly and efficiently. We keep a large stack of museum glass in-house that we can cut in custom sizes. The anti-reflective coating is on both sides for optimal performance. We also have expert packagers who are there to swiftly and promptly package the glass so it doesn't arrive broken. We also accept CAD drawings, PDFs, and JPEG images of special shapes. Just shoot us an email and what you need, and we'll provide you a quote as quickly as possible. Alright guys, that's all I have for you on anti-reflective glass. If you found this video helpful, go ahead and hit that subscribe button so you don't miss out on next week's content. Thank you so much for tuning in today. I'm Jessica with Optical Mirror, and I'll see you guys in my next video. And now, a message from our sponsors, us. A lot of you have been asking how I make my videos. Right now, I'm standing in front of a chroma key backdrop. By combining this with a teleprompter, I'm able to carefully plan and research my script in advance. Because I'm using a green screen, adding visuals during editing is super simple. Now, I'm gonna let you in on a little secret. Teleprompters are simple. A teleprompter is just a beam splitter mirror that displays my script in front of a camera. Using a teleprompter allows me to relax when I deliver my lines, resulting in a stress-free delivery with a well-prepared script. Because I'm not hung up on remembering my lines, it lets me focus more on how I deliver them, my tone of voice, charm, and body language. The magic is in the transparent mirror, which provides tint-free visibility for my camera to record through. Because the notes are in front of the camera lens, I can keep direct eye contact with you. Here's an example. Hi, I'm Jessica, videographer, model, and everything else that I want to be. I created this informative guide on anti-reflective glass to help you decide if higher quality glass is ideal for your next project.